Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and through you to the membership. America is the greatest nation in the world.
Purpose of the gentleman rise. The gentleman is having difficulty hearing the gentleman at the microphone. Again, the members will please subdue their conversation, take their seats, and pay attention to the gentleman at the microphone. Chair recognizes Mr. Lombardo of Billerica.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you to the gentleman from Andover. And it's worth repeating, America is truly the greatest nation in the world. And it's no wonder why millions of people around the world seek to come to America. They want to come here to find a better life. They want to find an opportunity to live the American dream. And so many seek to come to America with all of the best intentions. Colleagues, I ask you to reflect on 9/11. I ask you to reflect on the attacks at Fort Hood. And sadly, just recently, our attacks here at the Boston Marathon. There are those in the world that do want to hurt us and want to come to America and attack our very way of life. As a nation, as a commonwealth, we should do everything that we can to dissuade those who are coming to this country, seek to come to this country illegally, by doing so by breaking the rules. We need to eliminate a magnet for those who come here not following the rules. I think we made this point yesterday, and it's worth repeating, that $1.8 billion annually is spent on those who are breaking the rules. And it's because we have set up magnets for those individuals to come here. When we discuss sanctuary cities, what we have is a place for those who break the rules, either with best intentions or maybe those with not so best intentions, to come under the cover of darkness and have protection from the laws of this land. Because they are in cities or towns that have declared that they will not follow the rules of the immigration policy of this country. We should not be enabling that position. So I urge you to join me in an effort to keep our community safe and support this amendment. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. When you compare us to Arizona, a border state, a state that said, we have had enough, that we can no longer provide benefits and be a magnet to those who want to break the rules. Their legislature took action. And as a result, illegal immigration, the illegal immigrant population in Arizona has dropped. The cost of providing benefit to those individuals has dropped. Yet here in Massachusetts, it seems that we want to encourage that type of illegal activity. So what does it mean? We are sending a message to the world that if you want to come to America, if you want to jump in front of the line, in front of the good people that did it the right way, you want to break the rules, come to Massachusetts. Come to one of our sanctuary cities, and we will provide you a cover. And while you're here, you can get a piece of the $1.8 billion in benefits that we're giving out. And, you know, there's another comment about anti-immigration rhetoric. And I'm sure that wasn't directed at me on a personal level, because I come from a family of immigrants. My great-grandparents came through Ellis Island. They got in line. They did their paperwork. They learned the language of this country. They worked hard. They did not take advantage of any government program. They lived the American dream. They did things by the rules. They followed the law of the lands. And that is what we should be encouraging. Not those who break the rules to come to Massachusetts, but those that want to live the American dream and are willing to do it by the law. I encourage my colleagues to support this amendment. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.